Buckingham Palace has issued a rare statement following the release of the so-called palace letters, which reveal secret correspondence leading up to the sacking of then-Prime Minister Gough Whitlam. Federal politics reporter Jonathan Kersley is following the story. And Jono, what did the palace say?
Essentially still arguing the letters shouldn't have been released by the High Court, Ali, but the palace did say that this was evidence that the Queen had no role in one of the most historic events in Australian politics. We saw after 45 years and a very long court battle, these letters between Sir John Kerr, the then Governor-General, and the Queen's private secretary about the sacking of Gough Whitlam and his government in 1975 were finally made public. There had long been questions about what role, if any, the Queen and the palace had in the dismissal, but in the letters, the Governor-General said that he didn't want to inform the Queen of his decision before he'd made it. That was respected by the palace, which said the crisis was Australia's and Australia's alone to fix. But there were earlier discussions in the weeks prior to that historic day on 11 November 1975 about the powers available to Sir John Kerr, and the palace said they should only be used as a last resort. In a rare public statement, the palace last night said, while the royal household believes in the long-standing convention that all the conversations between prime ministers, governor-generals and the Queen are private, the release of the letters confirms that neither Her Majesty nor the royal household had any part to play in Kerr's decision to dismiss Whitlam. So, Ali, the big question, does this put this whole issue to bed? Well, there's now 1,200 pages of material that were never on the public record until now. That's plenty for historians to pore over. There's the other argument too over who should be our head of state. And that one, well, that's far from concluded.
It's a lot of reading, Jono. Get to it. Thanks, buddy.
Yeah, come back to us in half an hour with What's in Store.